All right, what's up, everybody? Welcome to another episode of Stand Tall. It is November 14th, and we're in Chapter 3 of The Art of War, Verse 4. The rule is not to besiege walled cities if it can possibly be avoided. The preparation of mantlets, movable shelters, and various implements of war will take up 3 whole months, and the piling up of mounds against the walls will take 3 months more. So, trying to take down a walled city or to besiege a city is time consuming. And I think time is probably one of the most precious assets that we have that we need to protect as much as possible. Master Sun says, take 3 months to prepare your machines and 3 months to complete your siege engineering. Dumu says that Sun Tzu means it is necessary to take time to really prepare machines and constructions thoroughly, lest many people be injured. As one of the ancient strategists said, those who cannot deploy their machines effectively are in trouble. Mei Yao Chen says, if neither intimidation nor intelligence are sufficient to overcome people and you have no choice but to attack them where they live, then you must take adequate time to prepare. So if it is your last resort, make sure that you're doing the proper things to prepare. Zhang Yu says, some say Master Sun's point here is that you shouldn't get angry and rush to attack. This is why he says take time, not because there's necessarily a specific time. Okay, I like what Zhang Yu says here, because, you know, what took 3 months and 3 months more back in the day, you know, 47 years ago, might not take as long today. But the point remains that you need to really take your time and plan and prep if you're going to do, you know, the last resort or the lowest form of generalship, depending on which version you want to use. So guard your time. All right, let's hop over to the Daily Stoic and find out what Western Stoicism meeting Eastern warfare philosophy can provide us with insight into for our daily lives. November 15th, everything is change. Meditate often as the swiftness with which all that exists and is coming into being is swept by us and carried away. For substance is like a river's unending flow. Its activity is continually changing and causes infinitely shifting so that almost nothing at all stands still. Marcus Aurelius, Meditations 5.23. Marcus borrows this wonderful metaphor from Heraclitus, who said, no man steps into the same river twice, because the river has changed, and so has the man. Life is a constant state of change, and so are we. To get upset by things is to wrongly assume that we will last. To kick ourselves or blame others is grabbing at the wind. To resent change is to wrongly assume that you have a choice in the matter. Everything is change. Embrace that. Flow with it. So, no matter what change comes our way, that's why we're studying the art of war as well, right? Because we know that through Stoicism, that whatever the obstacle is the way, and that we just have to deal with whatever is presented to us. And the art of war gives us the perspective of trying to know what all obstacles could be put in the way so that we may better have an idea of what to deal with when we get there. And through all of this, all of these meditations and looking at Marcus and looking at Sun Tzu and, you know, all of the principles that we read, whether it be like Ray Dalio or whatever greats are out there, they are to better help guide us. That way we're not lost, and that way we can keep standing tall.